Blackstone presents The Rent Collector, adapted for young readers, by Camron Wright. This book is read by Emily Wu Zeller. To the provider of hopes, dreams, and second chances. When you realize how perfect everything is, you will tilt your head back and laugh at the sky. Buddha. Author's note. Dear reader, what if you lived in a garbage dump? What would your life be like? Worse, what if you couldn't read? What if you'd never been taught the sounds letters make? What if you didn't know how to spell or write? Welcome to life at Stung Min Che, the largest garbage dump in all of Cambodia. It was at the dump where my son Trevor first met Sang Lee and her family. Trevor is a filmmaker and he shot a documentary of her family's story, called River of Victory. Sang Lee's son was deathly sick. She had no money and didn't know how to help him get better. But she never gave up hope. She always kept trying. When I watched the footage of the film, and later when I met Sang Lee in person at the dump, I admired her determination. I realized that I have a lot more in common with the people who live at Stung Min Che than I had previously thought. We all do. Sang Lee wanted the same things for her family that anyone would. She wanted her children to get an education, her spouse to be successful in his work, her family to be safe and healthy. The lesson is clear. No matter where we live, we are all just people. We're trying to do our best in our own situations, and even though we all come from very different backgrounds, we have more in common, shared goals and desires that hold us together as people, than we have differences that drive us apart. It was this realization that pushed me to write The Rent Collector. While it is fiction, it was inspired by Sang Lee and her family, and it also examines the importance of reading and of stories in our lives. You may not live in the kind of poverty that the families and children experience at Stung Min Che, but even in America, there are parents today who aren't sure how they're going to feed their children. As you read this story, if you're one of the lucky ones who can go to school and learn, who eats three meals a day, who has electricity, running water, and an actual toilet in your house, be grateful. Give your mom or dad a hug. Write a thank you note to your teacher. Give thanks for the little things like sleeping in an actual bed instead of lying on cardboard. There are children everywhere who aren't as fortunate. I invite you now into Sang Lee's world, living in a Cambodian garbage dump. Because even in the most difficult places on earth, or during the hardest times of our lives, we never know who is going to cross our path, help us gain courage, and change us forever. Sincerely, Camron Wright. Chapter 1. Life in a Garbage Dump.
Beep, beep, beep.
A steady rumble of trucks tries to pry into the safety of my dream. It's a dream where I am a child prancing along a trail in Cambodia's countryside. I'm heading toward the rice fields where my family works. It's a cheerful morning as I pull at my grandfather's bony fingers. I tug him along while he struggles to keep up.
Hurry, slow one, I say with a smug bounce.
I am moving slowly, he answers. But someday, so will you.
I shrug, then pounce like a frog from rock to rock along the path. But then I stop and turn.
Grandfather, when I get old, what will my life be like?
He shuffles to a stop. His gaze sharpens. His head tilts. His attention shifts to the surrounding fields. Then we both feel the ground beneath us tremble. He bends close, as if peeking into my thoughts. I glance down at my bare and dirty toes, but he won't allow it. His finger touches my chin to raise my gaze. His voice is firm, but with enough grandfatherly glee to make sure my little girl ears pay attention to every syllable.
Life will not always be so hard and cruel.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.